From millions of artifacts in the Henry Ford's digital collections, our experts choose three and reveal the surprisingly curious connections between them.
What do a can of condensed milk, Kleenex tissue, and Silly Putty have in common? Prior to the 19th century, soldiers were accustomed to eating spoiled food. The foods that traveling militaries carried quickly rotted. In response to this military need, airtight canning was perfected in 1810. In the 1850s, American Gail Borden successfully preserved milk by reduction. Borden sold their condensed milk for the first time in 1858. Canned food was revolutionary for its time and came to change the way that people all over the world experienced food. Historically, cotton was used as wound dressing. A cotton shortage caused by the casualties of World War I provided an opportunity for Kimberly-Clark Corporation to introduce their new cellucotton material as an effective wound dressing. At the end of World War I, Kimberly-Clark had a surplus of this new material, and with the surplus, Kleenex facial tissue was born. In the years leading up to and during World War II, the U.S. government sought the invention of a synthetic rubber as a dire shortage loomed. Even Thomas Edison experimented with creating a synthetic rubber. An engineer from General Electric succeeded in creating a new rubber-like substance. However, it was too soft for use in the war effort. A marketing consultant recognized that the new substance may appeal to children as a toy. Silly Putty quickly became a favorite plaything of American children. Wartime, throughout the centuries, has created situations of severe necessity and great innovation. We typically think of tanks and guns as products of wartime, but even some common goods, such as Kleenex, Silly Putty, or canned food have wartime roots.